Hi, this is Jennifer Bagley with CIO Web Group, and I've been asked to do a quick video on pioneerenergyresources.com. On the left-hand side, you'll see the website analysis. On the right-hand side, you'll see the physical site. We're going to go through, and this is going to be kind of quick because it's in an ASP site, so we've got quite a bit of difficulty in accomplishing the necessary things that Google and other search engines are requiring or requesting in order to crawl the site, properly place the site, and so forth. I hate to do this. I don't like going over bad news, but it's important for all business owners to know where they stand, and not knowing these numbers is way more expensive than doing it right. So we're going to kind of go through it with that approach. The website is currently grading at 18 out of 100. That's very low. Again, I just noticed right off the bat it was an ASP site, which is pretty typical. There is no integrated blog on the site that is legible by Google. So I'm going to open up the blog area right here. Basically, what has happened is the energy site has created a free blog on a subdomain under the WordPress environment. So you'll see pioneerenergyresources.wordpress.com. I'm not going to go fully into subdomains other than your most valuable asset on your website is your blog, and taking it and placing it inside a free subdomain on a WordPress completely eliminates the use of this engine. Now, even if it looks like you guys are using it for something other than a blog anyway, because everything's password protected, there's not a lot of posts on here. I'm not sure I understand why that would be the case, but if you want your website to generate traffic and that traffic to convert to leads and that leads to convert to opportunities, then we got to get out of this environment. This is not going to help. So that's why it's not evaluating the blog. Now, as far as the content not being legible or readable by Google, we'll go through, quickly look at the page, and we have basically the whole site, typical of ASP. The whole site is designed in a table. So I'm going to delete the table, which is called tabular data. This is what we're leaving for Google. You just have to replace the site. There's not a lot you can do with this. So there's no index pages. Google can't read the content on the site. The only information we're giving to Google about the particular site is that it's called Pioneer Energy Resources. We don't use any primary search phrases. The site has no headings can be found. There may be headings on the site, but when we put that inside, and I don't think there is. Yeah, big header one that's using a class. It's supposed to be an H tag. When you put it inside a table, it doesn't matter anyway because it's all in this tabular data. It's like reading a newspaper with no content. None of the interior pages can be analyzed by Google. The site's been online for 1 year, 6 months, and 1 week. Expires in 5 months. So as soon as possible, you're going to want to extend your domain name past this 5 month mark. When you do that, you're also going to want to tell them you need a 301 redirect on the site. Right now, Google thinks Pioneer Energy Resources with the W's and without the W's are two different sites. Your Google PageRank is 0 out of 10. That's really a trust factor. Right now, there's not a lot you can do because of the way the site was built. Backlinks, you have one backlink right now, but it's not from an authoritative site. There's no mobile optimization in the site, no social media integration, no RSS feed. There is one form on the site, very little marketing automation, and your traffic rank is at the 18% mark. So traffic is, majority of traffic all is in the top 3%. The site just needs to be kind of brought down and replaced. There's not a lot to it. I don't see a lot of customization or anything crazy as far as how it was built. I'd have to go through and double check. Actually, let me go through this daily matrix. What does this do? So I'm not sure what the Daily Matrix does, but that may be something that's more custom coding. Your live chat looks like a third-party embed code. That's fine. Your newsletter system, just an embedded form. I can't get the video one to work. Video one doesn't work. So I think you're golden. Fix a site, and then definitely engage in an on-page and an off-page SEO plan. Proper social media integration into the site, and then really you guys are going to want to learn, train, get coached, make sure that you're involved in a coaching and training program to teach you how to leverage this technology, how to get this technology to generate leads. On the site, we have to really, really take a look at the site, create calls to actions that we can have implemented in the site, as well as tie the website into a CRM. And within the CRM, we need to have forms that will allow you to capture leads at different levels throughout the site. So right now, it doesn't matter. You don't need to do that. Without having a lot of traffic, it's not necessary to concentrate on conversions, but it will be soon. So I hope this is a little bit helpful. At least it'll give you some ideas to discuss internally and externally and some things to look out for. Again, I'm Jennifer Bagley with CI Web Group. If you have another website you'd like us to review, please go to www.ciwebgroup.com/video. ciwebgroup.com/video. And we'd be happy to take care of that for you. Thanks again, and we look forward to seeing you online.